On segment two tonight, we hit the road and visit a remote corner of the Southern California desert. It's a spot where thousands of people gather each winter. They arrive in dusty station wagons and rusty pickup trucks, shiny RVs and weather-beaten buses. They're people who have chosen a road less traveled. And as Bob McKenzie reports, home is on the range.
California's Imperial Valley is not a recommended place to be in July when the temperature hits 120 degrees. But winter is another story. Try January when a 75-degree afternoon is normal. About 30 years ago, some meandering campers found an abandoned marine base here where concrete slab foundations made a perfect place to park a trailer, and there was no landowner around to collect rent. Gradually, word got around about the perfect winter weather and about the free rent. More people started showing up here in the fall and staying until spring. Now there are at least 1,000 people who spend the winters here. They call it Slab City, or just the Slabs.
Nobody bothers us out here.
The phones don't ring, and you know, just a good kickback life.
They begin arriving in October, and by December, they have spread over a five-mile radius in everything from $1,500 trailers to $80,000 motorhomes. In what could be a preview of a post-apocalyptic society, there's no rent to pay here, but no services either. No piped-in water, no gas or electricity. What pass for community services are supplied by entrepreneurs. One man figured out he could make money hauling away garbage. He bought an old truck and charges 50 cents a bag. Shower is free though, irrigation water warmed by the desert sun. Most of the Slab citizenry are retirees from places that are cold in the winter. These Slab City neighbors all hail from the state of Washington, where some still keep homes.
Now what does that four bedroom house do while you're down here?
It gets broken into.
It just got broken into this year.
Others have sold their homes and become full-time snowbirds, living in a motorhome and following the sun.
Did it scare you at all, selling your house and not having a home base anymore?
No, sir. Not a bit. Not a bit. It's just so much pressure.
So you like being free of that?
Yes, absolutely.
Harry and Dora Bernard say nobody bothers them in Slab City.
It's freedom to do as you wish.
I like the wide openness of it. Our neighbors are not close to us. And like we said, we make new neighbors every year.
There are really two populations in Slab City, the snowbirds who pull out in the spring, and the year-rounders, people who live here full-time, enduring a punishing summer because they can't afford to live anywhere else.
I'm living on SSI, and if I were living in the Bay Area, I wouldn't be able to afford rent there, or hardly any place. Then I can live here without paying rent, and I can be around my grandkids.
The snowbirds are wary of the year-rounders and keep their distance. But a few year-rounders have won their respect. Sally Vanderbilt and her husband have to stay through the summer to survive on his Social Security retirement check. They have a thriving garden and keep a spotless, perfectly maintained trailer home.
We just, you know, hang in there and take it a day at a time. It's all you can do anyway, you know, and so far it's been good.
The Vanderbilt's only mishap last summer was when their thermometer hit 125 degrees and exploded. There's no need to be alone in the desert, Slab citizens say. Numerous social clubs have sprung up here. This one, the Slab City Singles, offers a daily happy hour.
And we're going to go up to Portside. And we're going to go to Las Vegas.
We didn't see any heavy drinking here. The members busy themselves at cribbage or card games, or try their hand at painting, or join in the beanbag tournament. Peggy Webb is making flowers for the float the club will enter in a local tomato festival parade. She and her husband sold their house in 1995 and hit the road. She says she recommends it.
Because you have to be able to live like a gypsy. That's what my mother calls me. She couldn't live this way. But, you know, if you can be without a house and go from place to place, it's wonderful.
Night falls early in the winter, and here it usually brings a spectacular sunset, each one different from the last. And when darkness comes, it's time to sit around a campfire with friends, trading bits of gossip and talking about those awful winters back home. In the Imperial Valley, Bob McKenzie, and that's segment two.